You're a thinking person. How can you choose this lifestyle?
What is so incredibly great about New York? It's a dying city. You read Death in Venice.
You didn't read Death in Venice till I gave it to you.
Well, you only give me books with the word death in the title.
It's an important issue.
Artie, you are totally incapable of enjoying life. You're like New York. You're an island.
Okay. If that's all that we've been through together means to you, I guess it's better if we just said goodbye, once and for all. You know what's funny? After all the serious talks and passionate moments, that it ends here, in a health food restaurant on Sunset Boulevard. Goodbye, Sally.
Wait. I'm gonna go with you. I love you.
What do you want? It was my first play. You know how you're always trying to get things to come out perfect in art, because it's real difficult in life. Interestingly, however, I did run into Annie again. It was on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. She had moved back to New York. She was living in Soho with some guy. And when I met her, she was, of all things, dragging him in to see The Sorrow and the Pity, which I counted as a personal triumph. And Annie and I, we had lunch sometime after that and kicked around old times.
Just to have my arms around you. Still the thrill that it was the day I found you seems like
after that, it got pretty late, and we both had to go, but it was great seeing Annie again. I realized what a terrific person she was, and how much fun it was just knowing her. And I thought of that old joke, you know, this guy goes to a psychiatrist and says, Doc, my brother's crazy. He thinks he's a chicken. And the doctor says, well, why don't you turn him in? And the guy says, I would, but I need the eggs. Well, I guess that's pretty much now how I feel about relationships. You know, they're totally irrational and crazy and absurd, but I guess we keep going through it because most of us need the eggs.
You